Hi everyone. A couple of months ago, Cisco announced that a new version of the CCNA exam is coming soon. In the past, each time Cisco updated an exam, it got a new exam code. But now, they're keeping the same exam code and simply adding a version number. So the new version of the exam will be 200-301, version 1.1. This is old news by now. Cisco announced the exam update back in April. So the purpose of this video is to tell you my plans for the new version. But before we get into that, let's briefly look at the changes. The last date to test for the current version of the exam, version 1.0, is August 19th, 2024. And then from August 20, the changes will take effect. You might be wondering, how much of the exam is actually changing? Cisco says that approximately 10% of the CCNA exam is updated. In my opinion, 10% is a major overestimation. Looking at the new topics, you can probably learn them in a few hours of study. It's not a big deal. So, what exactly are the new topics? Let's take a look. First, here is section 2.5, all about spanning tree protocol. Version 1.0 mentions portfast in exam topic 2.5c, but no other optional features are mentioned. Version 1.1 adds 2.5d, adding loopguard, rootguard, BPDU filter, and BPDU guard. My course already covers BPDU guard, but the others are new, so I'll make another video to cover them. Okay, next is topic 2.8. Version 1.0 says to describe AP and WLC management access. So, talking about different ways to connect to and configure wireless access points and controllers, such as the CLI via the console port, telnet, and SSH, or the GUI via HTTP and HTTPS. Version 1.1 expands the topic to include all network devices. Describe network device management access. It also adds the words cloud managed to the end. I already cover cloud managed wireless APs in the current version of my course. Cisco Meraki, a company Cisco acquired back in 2012, offers cloud managed wireless access points. But other devices can be managed with a cloud platform too. So I'll expand the coverage to address the topic of cloud management in general, not just from the perspective of Wi-Fi. Next, topic 6.4. Compare traditional campus device management with Cisco DNA Center-enabled device management. In version 1.1, this topic has been removed and replaced, covering AI and machine learning. It says to explain AI, generative and predictive, and machine learning in network operations. AI and machine learning are obviously hot topics at the moment, and I think it's fair to say that they have the potential to bring network automation to the next level, and also take all of our jobs, but that's a problem for the future. This topic expects you to have a general understanding of how AI and machine learning work at a high level, and also some applications in networking. Next is topic 6.5, describe characteristics of REST-based APIs. Version 1.1 simply adds authentication types to the things you need to know about REST APIs. So things like API keys, OAuth 2.0, etc. Finally, there is topic 6.6. Recognize the capabilities of configuration management mechanisms such as Puppet, Chef, and Ansible. Version 1.1 removes Puppet and Chef and adds Terraform instead, and Ansible remains. This change was expected. In terms of market share, Puppet and Chef are far behind Ansible and Terraform, and they aren't used for managing networks very often. So I'll update the video in my course to focus on Ansible and Terraform, but I'll still briefly mention Puppet and Chef. So those are all of the changes in version 1.1. Cisco also updated the wording of some other topics, but those are just wording changes. They don't change the actual content. For example, topic 4.5 changed syslog levels to syslog severity levels. Same meaning, they just clarified the wording. Okay, let's move on to the main topic of this video. What am I going to do about the new version? First of all, my book, Acing the CCNA Exam, which has two volumes, is being printed right now and should be ready to ship soon. And the book addresses version 1.1, including all of the new topics. AI and machine learning, REST API authentication, Terraform, etc. The topics we just looked at. I will also update my practice exams, which you can get at courses.jeremysitlab.com, to cover the new exam topics. I'll release the new versions on August 20th, the same day as the new exam. And what about my video course? I think that's what everyone really wants to know. The simplest thing to do would be to just make a few videos covering the new topics and add them to the course. But I think this is a good opportunity to refresh the course a bit. So over the next few months, in addition to adding videos for the new topics, I will also be uploading new versions of older videos too. Subnetting, VLAN, spanning tree, dynamic routing, the entire wireless and automation sections, and maybe more. It's going to take some time to make those videos, but I think it's a good time to upgrade the course and bring it to the next level. So those are my plans for the new version of the CCNA exam. Before I finish, let me address one question that you might have. If you're already studying for the current version of the CCNA exam, what should you do? My advice is simply to continue studying. As I said before, the changes are very minor, and you should be able to learn the new topics in a few hours of studying. So if you won't be ready to take version 1.0 of the exam before August 20th, don't worry about it. You can easily learn the new topics and take version 1.1 instead. Okay, thanks for watching, and look forward to new videos in my CCNA course coming soon.